Hi, everybody. My name is Ansel Litton. I have been in Gibbon for 7 years. Last year was my first year on the secretariat.
My name is Cami Hathaway. I've been in Gibbon for 2 years. I was a delegate for 2 years. This is my first year on the secretariat.
My name is Arthur Roman. I've been a delegate for 2 years, and this is my first year on the secretariat.
So today we are presenting UNICEF, the United Nations Children's Fund. UNICEF was established on December 11, 1946. It was established after World War II as a way to help children around the world who were affected by the conflicts during World War II. It's active in over 190 countries, so it has a pretty global reach. You can turn to page 54 in your notebooks if you want to follow along. And while we're doing this presentation, at any time if you have a question, just feel free to raise your hand and we'll answer.
One of the topics we're going to talk about is children protection and development. So nearly one quarter of the homeless population are children. So especially in developing countries, there are many children who do not have access to shelter or homes. And with this, they also don't have access to food or water, which leaves them dehydrated and like starving. And the UNICEF is trying its best to provide them with developmental aid so they have access to supplies they need to survive.
Medical care for children in developing nations. Okay, so around 9 million children die each year, mostly in developing nations, and the majority of these deaths could have been easily prevented with the correct medical care. So that's in developed nations, we take for granted the medical care we have, the access to doctors regularly, the vaccines. That's not something that they have in a lot of developing nations, so it's become a very big problem, child mortality, because children's immune systems, they're not as strong as adults, so they're much more likely to die of dangerous diseases in those countries since they don't have the correct treatment. Can anybody tell me what SDG number 3 is? They're on the back of your notebook.
Good health and well-being.
So see, that relates to this. So the SDGs are important goals that we need to strive for in the United Nations.
So child poverty is a really big issue in the world. So like before, developing countries have the most child poverty, and over 1 billion children live in poverty. So most don't have access to food or water, and if they do, it's very little and limited. And also UNICEF is trying its best to provide these resources for children so they can grow up to have a better well-being, and so they can like develop into better women and men. Children impacted by the Syrian crisis. So in Syria, there's been like war going on for a really long time now, and so there's been mass destruction and violence happening, and so children are affected by this destruction because their houses are taken away from them, their family members could die too, so they are alone and don't have anywhere to live or go. If they do have anywhere to live, it's mainly in refugee camps that don't have a lot of access to food and water either. And UNICEF is trying its best to provide humanitarian aid to children who don't have shelter to live in and don't have food or water.
Children with disabilities are often not treated the same as children without disabilities. They are not provided equal health care or education. Most children with disabilities will have higher death rates due to the fact that they do not have the proper health care that they need. UNICEF works towards aiding the children with disabilities throughout the world. UNICEF works to rescue and aid families and children affected by disaster. This could be man-made or natural disasters. Presently in Kenya, does anyone know where that is? There's a conflict over political views that could lead to war. Recently, the world has been affected by many natural disasters, such as earthquakes, tornadoes, hurricanes. Does anyone have an example of one of those? Yes.
The hurricane that is affecting Puerto Rico.
Child refugees. A refugee is defined as a person who has been forced to leave their country. Child refugees can be affected in negatively in many ways. They can suffer PTSD and other mental disorders. They are oftentimes forced to sleep outside, which can lead to many varying sicknesses. In 2016 alone, 26,000 children were escaping violence, abuse, poverty, and or deprivation in their countries. Does anyone know what poverty is? Yes.
The lack of economic stability.
Yes. What about deprivation? Well, yes.
Lack of deprivation in which sense?
Just like in an overall stance.
Deprivation is when you lack something.
UNICEF works to aid these children and their families during these tough times.
Okay, so before we move on to open agenda, are there any questions about any of the topics we've discussed so far? No? Okay, so now we're going to move on to open agenda. You have to choose one of the topics that we've discussed or that are in your books. And we actually really like it when you choose something different and creative. It makes everything more interesting. It makes it where people have less of the same topics sometimes. Just make sure it is relevant to UNICEF. No off-topic things. Are there any examples of some topics you could do that we didn't discuss today?
No?
Yeah.
For example, you could do something here in the United States, for example, about making sure that children have the ability to have like practice in school, for example.
That's a good one. Helping the children who may not have the resources to have their own breakfast, having breakfast in the schools, that's a program that's in a lot of American schools. It's really helpful. So yeah, that has been our presentation. I hope you guys all enjoyed it.